and welcome to Obsidian Soft. In today's tutorial, I will teach you how to make a basic calculator in MIT App Inventor. Our front end will look like this. You can use different colors for your app. Let's first look at a short demo of this calculator app. As you can see that it has all the basic operators, plus, minus, multiplication, and division, and they are working nicely. So let's begin with the class. First, go to Projects. Click on Start New Project. Name it Calculator. So we have our screen that we have to design here. And first we're going to change its title, Screen 1, to Calculator. So I'm just going to go down and change the title of my Screen 1 to Calculator. And the next thing is that inside the properties, we want to change its screen orientation to Portrait. So right now it's unspecified, so I'm going to choose Portrait here, okay? I'm also going to turn off the status bar so that I have the entire screen available for my calculator app. So for turning it off, just uncheck Show Status Bar. And all these changes I've made in Screen 1's properties, okay? Next, we have to add some arrangements. So coming down, I'm going to choose Layout. From here, I'm going to add, first of all, a vertical arrangement. This will be our calculator screen in which our answer and question both will be displayed, okay? I'm going to rename it to Calc Screen. As you know from my previous classes, I focus a lot on renaming the components because it makes your code more readable. And renaming the buttons is especially essential while you are working in the block section because you might end up writing the wrong code for some button if you have not renamed it properly. I'm going to make this calc screen, the vertical arrangement, align horizontal to be on the right because I want my answer and my question to be displayed towards the right side of the screen, and align vertical will be center so that the digits and the question and the answer, they come exactly in the center vertically. I'm going to make its width fill parent, but the height will be 40%. And I'm also going to make the background color black. Next, I'm going to add two labels to it. So I'm going to go to user interface and add one label and the second label. I'm going to rename the top one question and make its font size 50. I'm also going to make its text color as light gray, and I'm going to remove the text from it. Similarly, I will rename the second label as the answer, but I will make it a bit bigger than my question. So font size 60, removing the text and making the text color white. Next, we have to add some arrangements for our buttons. So I'm going to make 5 horizontal arrangements. I'm going to add them one by one. So the first arrangement, make its width fill parent and height is 12%. How am I arriving at these percentages? I've done some calculations. So I've given 40% to my calc screen and 12% I will give to all my arrangements that will hold the buttons. Okay. So 12 times 5 is 60. 60 plus 40 is 100. Make this horizontal arrangement, align horizontal center and align vertical center. And I'm going to make the background color light blue. Next, I'm going to add 4 more arrangements and I will give exactly the same properties as this arrangement. Vertical center, color is light blue, height is 12%, width is fill parent. So let's add the other 3. So I'm done with all the 5 arrangements, horizontal arrangements. And as you can see that my last arrangement is not visible. This is the problem with our designer view in MIT App Inventor, but it will be definitely visible when you will test the app using the MIT Companion app. If I shift my display to tablet size, this will still be a bit visible. So I'm going to keep it like this so that you're able to see the 5th arrangement. Okay. Now I'm going to start adding buttons. The top 4 arrangements will have 4 buttons and the last arrangement will have 1 big equal to button. Okay. So this top arrangement will have 7, 8, 9 and division button. So let me go to user interface and start adding the buttons. We are going to first add this button for number 7. Now here renaming is super important. 7 button. I'm going to make its font bold, font size 35, shape is rounded, and I'm going to make the width of the button 23%. Okay, so I've done some maths here, and I'm going to make the background color light gray. Again, you can choose a different background color. And last but not the least, I'm going to change the text to number 7. The digit 7. Next, I'm going to add a label after this number 7 on the right. This is to put a gap between all the buttons, because otherwise all these buttons will be touching each other. So let me add a label here. I'm just going to make its width 2%. Okay, and yes, empty the text. Okay, so again, another button, same properties as the 7 button. I'm going to first rename it. This is my 8 button, and I'm going to make the font bold, font size 35, I'm going to make the width 23%, and I'm going to make the background color light gray, shape rounded, removing the text and making it 8. I'm going to put another label after this, remove the text, make the width 2%. Okay, so 9 will come here and then the division 1. So let me quickly add the 9. I can use a slash for the division symbol, or I can go to Google, type in division symbol and just copy this. And I can come back here, and instead of that slash division symbol, I can paste that division symbol that you normally see in your calculators. As you can see that now it has been updated. Now similarly, I'm going to add 4 more buttons here. 3 will be digits and 1 will be the operator. For this row, we will have 4, 5, 6 digit buttons and the multiplication button. Unfortunately, I cannot duplicate it, so I just have to do it again. So 4, 5, 6 and multiplication for the second row. For the third row, we will have 1, 2, 3 and minus button. And for the fourth row, we will have 0 and an AC button, that is the all clear button, a decimal point button, that is just a normal dot, and a plus button. And I will make the AC button and the decimal point button orange in color to make it a bit different. So I'm just going to quickly go ahead and do it. In the last row, I'm just going to have 1 button, but the background color will be orange, font bold, font size 35, and the only difference is that the width is 50%, so that it takes up more of the screen, and the shape is again rounded, and text is the equal to sign. And I'm going to rename it to equal to button. Okay. Sorry, I just noticed that the width was not changed because I think I forgot to press OK. So pressing OK is super important. So just remember to press OK. So when you press OK, the changes will be registered. Now we're done with the front end. So let's quickly go to the block section. We will not be able to complete the entire app in this tutorial, but let's begin with some of it. I need 3 global variables. First number, second number, and operator that will contain our question that has to be calculated by our calculator. So the names are self-explanatory. So I'm going to go to variables, initialize first number. And interestingly, I'm not going to initialize it to a math block. I'm going to use text block for it. And the reason for this is when a person uses our app and presses the buttons, the digit buttons, if he or she presses a number 3 digit button and then presses some other digit button, that digit should be appended, should be joined to the first digit. And for this purpose, we need to have our global variable first number and the second number as text so that we can join all the digits that are being pressed by the user. Okay, so duplicate. This is now the second number. duplicate, and this is our operator that will contain the operation that the user wants to perform, that is plus, minus, multiplication or division. Okay, now we're going to make a procedure. Why do we need a procedure? Our procedure will be for making up the question depending upon what the user has pressed on the screen, what number key they have pressed, what operator they have pressed. And as this kind of code will be called multiple times when the user presses a digit key, so we should put it inside a procedure. Whenever you have some repetitive code that you want to call multiple times, use multiple times, always put it inside the procedure. So I'm going to go to procedure and make this procedure, and I'm going to call it make question. So this procedure is for showing the question on the calculator screen to the user. So I will be basically setting up the text of my label question. So I'm going to go to question and I'm going to get this set question.txt, and I'm going to join the first number, second number operator in the correct order. So I'm going to go to text and I'm going to use this join. But as you can see, it has only two slots. So we can add multiple slots by dragging the string here. And I need five slots. Why five? When we only have three variables, because I want some space between the different variables. Okay. So I'm going to go to variables and I'm going to get the get block. Make it first number. I'm going to go to text. Now this is important, and I'm going to tap on it and intentionally put a space here. Okay, so now I can duplicate. Now this is my operator, because this is how you write a question, that is 32 plus 45. So operator will come in the middle, duplicate this block with a space in it, and then duplicate the operator and make it the second number. Now let's add the number key code. So whenever any number key, for example 7, is pressed, how do we know that number 7, the digit 7, should become a part of the first number or the second number? I mean, think about it. Whenever someone says the operator, that is 37 plus 42. So we know that 37 is the first number and 42 is the second number. And this is exactly how we are going to distinguish it in our coding too. That is, if the operator is empty, it means that whenever a user presses a number key, that number should become the part of the first number. But if the user has provided an operator, that is plus, minus, multiplication or division, this means that now, whatever number he will enter will become a part of the second number, will be appended to the second number. Okay, so that is the basic logic of it, and we are going to just do it in the code too. So when the 7 button, we are going to start with the number 7 key. So when 7 button is clicked, we are going to first of all look whether our operator is empty, and depending on that, we will join the 7 digit to either the first number or the second number. So I'm going to go to control and get the if then else block. And inside that, I'm going to check and compare operator with an empty string. So I'm going to go to text and I'm going to get this compare block. And here on the left hand side, I have the operator. So if I hover over it, I can get the getter for it. So get global operator, and if it is equal to, now this is important, if it is equal to empty, the empty string block, then I'm going to set my first number. Now remember that this means that the operator is empty, so this 7 should become the part of the first number, and I'm going to do a join. So I'm going to go to text and I'm going to join the first number. Again, I can hover over it and get the getter for it, and the digit 7. Okay, but I'm going to use the text for it, so I'm going to type in 7 here. And in the other scenario, this means that the operator was not empty, so I'm going to do exactly the same thing but for the second number. So just duplicate it by right clicking on it and make it the second number. Make sure that you do it on both sides. So if the operator is empty, join the 7 to whatever is already inside the first number. In the other case, that means the operator was not empty and the user had provided a plus, minus, multiplication or division operator. In this case, make some number 7 a part of the second number, join it in to whatever is inside the second number, okay? And last but not the least, call make question to reflect this change on the calculator screen. And this code, I will duplicate it for all the digits. That is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, and 9, okay? So make sure that you do it for all the digits and do not forget to do it for one of the digits. Then you will see that some of your number keys will not work, okay? So I'm doing it for starting from 0. I just duplicated the code for 7 button and just changed the text inside here. So I'm just made it 0. So this duplication is very easy and it makes our coding faster. So duplicate again by right clicking on it, change it to the 1 button, okay. Duplicating it again, choose it for 2 button, 2, 2, okay. So I'm going to do exactly the same for all the digits. We are done with all the digit button click code, okay. And we will complete this app in the next class. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, kindly do so that you don't miss the next class. And please share my video with your friends and family and support me in this way so that I continue to make these coding tutorials for you. We will complete this app in the next class. Thank you for watching my video. Have a good day and goodbye.